Good evening, everybody. Lovely to see you all. Welcome to our choral Evensong on this first Sunday of October. Our opening hymn is 208. It's part two of Christ has made a short foundation. Thank you, and the doxology. Absolution and remission of their sins. He pardoneth and absolveth all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore, let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so that at the last we may come to his eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
helps the poor. Now the men and their wives raised a great outcry against their Jewish brothers. Some were saying, "We and our sons and daughters are numerous. In order for us to eat and stay alive, we must get grain." Others were saying, "We are mortgaging our fields, our vineyards, and our homes to get grain during the famine." Still others were saying, "We have had to borrow money to pay the king's tax on our fields and vineyards. Although we are of the same flesh and blood as our countrymen, and though our sons are as good as theirs, yet we have to subject our sons and daughters to slavery. Some of our daughters have already been enslaved because our fields and our vineyards belong to others." When I heard their outcry and these charges, I was very angry. I pondered them in my mind and then accused the nobles and officials. I told them, "You are exacting usury from your own countrymen." So I called together a large meeting to deal with them and said, "As far as possible, we have bought back our Jewish brothers who were sold to the Gentiles. Now you are selling your brothers only for them to be sold back to us." They kept quiet because they could find nothing to say. So I continued, "What you are doing is not right. Shouldn't you walk in the fear of our God to avoid the reproach of our Gentile enemies? I and my brothers and my men are also lending the people money and grain. But let the exacting of usury stop. Give back to them immediately their fields, vineyards, olive groves and houses, and also the usury you are charging them, the hundredth part of the money, grain, new wine, and oil." "We will give it back," they said, "and we will not demand anything more from them. We will do as you say." Then I summoned the priests and made the nobles and officials take an oath to do what they had promised. I also shook out the folds of my robe and said, "In this way may God shake out of his house and possessions every man who does not keep this promise. So may such a man be shaken out and emptied." At this, the whole assembly said, "Amen," and praised the Lord. And the people did as they had promised. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen. man or his parents that he was born blind. Neither this man nor his parents sinned, said Jesus. But this happened so that the work of God might be displayed in his life. As long as it is day, we must do the work of him who sent him. Night is coming, when no one can work. While I am in the world, I am the light of the world. Having said this, he spat on the ground, made some mud with the saliva, and put it on the man's eyes. Go, he told him, wash in the pool of Siloam. This word means sent. So the man went and washed and came home, seeing. His neighbours, those who had formerly seen him, begging, asked, isn't this the same man who used to sit and beg? Some claimed that he was. Others said, no, he only looks like him. But he himself insisted, I am the man. How then were your eyes opened, they demanded. He replied, the man they called Jesus made some mud, put it on my eyes. He told me to go to Siloam and wash. So I went and washed, and then I could see. Where is this man? They asked him. I don't know, he said. They brought the Pharisees, the man who had been blind. Now the day on which Jesus had made the mother open the man's eyes was a Sabbath. Therefore the Pharisees also asked him how he had received his sight. He put mud on my eyes, the man replied, and I washed, and now I see. Some of the Pharisees said, this man is not from God, for he does not keep the Sabbath. But others asked, how can a sinner do such miraculous signs? So they were divided. Finally, they turned again to the blind man. What have you to say about him? It was your eyes he opened. The man replied, he is a prophet. The Jews still did not believe that he had been blind and had received his sight until they sent for the man's parents. Is this your son? They asked. Is this the one you say was born blind? How is it now that he can see? We know he is our son, the parents answered. And we know that he was born blind. But how can he see now, or who opened his eyes? We don't know. Ask him. He is of age. He will speak for himself. His parents said this because they were afraid of the Jews, for already the Jews had decided that anyone who acknowledged that Jesus was the Christ would be put out of the synagogue. That was why his parents said, he is of age. Ask him. A second time they summoned the man who had been blind. Give glory to God, they said. We know this man is a sinner. He replied, he is a sinner or not? I don't know. One thing I do know, I was blind, but now I see. When they asked him, what did he do to you? How did he open your eyes? He answered, I have told you already, and you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples too? Then they hurled insults at him and said, you are his fellow's disciple. We are disciples of Moses. We know that God spoke to Moses, but as for this fellow, we don't even know where he comes from. The man answered, now that is remarkable. You don't know where he comes from, yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners. He listens to the godly man who does his will. Nobody has ever heard of opening the eyes of a man born blind. If this man were not from God, he could do nothing. To this they replied, you are steeped in sin at birth. How dare you lecture us? And they threw him out. Jesus heard that they had thrown him out, and the Son of Man. Who is he, sir? The man asked. Tell me, so that I may believe in him. Jesus said, you have now seen him. In fact, he is the one speaking to you. Then the man said, Lord, I believe, and he worshipped him. Jesus said, for judgment I have come into this world, so that the blind will see, and those who will see will become blind. Some Pharisees who were with him heard him say this and asked, what? Are we blind too? Jesus said, if you were blind, you would not be guilty of sin. But now that you claim you can see, your guilt remains. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Saviour.
Amen.
Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thine own Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The anthem for this evening is How Lovely Are Thy Dwellings, by Noble Rawsthorne.
Thank you.
souls with your wonderful love and light. Give us strength and courage to reflect that love and light in the world. Let us never shrink back from whom we are in you, or hide our light inside ourselves. Renew in us a sense of joy, painting the dark shadows around us with your light, your love, and your salvation. Hear us today as we pray for a world too often darkened by hatred, evil, power, and greed. Within our darkest night, let your light shine. God of power and might, your broken world cries out from the depths. A world dominated by the darkness of war, terror, pain, and suffering. We think of the ongoing and deepening conflicts around the world. We share the pain and anguish of those who have had to flee from their homes, their countries and livelihoods, who risk their lives, desperate for a new start, free from fear and war. May they see your light, feel your strength and power, and know the truth of your promise, that we shall not be overcome by the dark shadows of life or the darkness of human nature. Within our darkest night, let your light shine. God of compassion and grace, we share with you our love and concern for people in darkness today. We have on our hearts friends and loved ones, and bring before you all who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. We pray that they will find your strength in the compassion and love of those around them. Let your light shine through the darkness of all their pain and suffering. Within our darkest night, let your light shine. God of life, we ask for your healing power on those who are enduring pain and illness. We share the grief of people close to us who've recently lost loved ones. We know your everlasting light shines with us in moments of great sadness and great joy. Within our darkest night, let your light shine. God of love and hope, renew in us a deeper sense of who we are in you. Help us to be aware of your presence each and every day. Make us instruments of love and praise. May our words, actions, and lives be living examples of your forgiving, healing, life-giving love. Within our darkest night, let your light shine.
Our offertory and closing hymn is As Now the Sun's Declining, is number 11.
As the sun's declining,
fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us all evermore. Amen.